Welcome to Tech Confidential. I'm Mary Kathleen Flynn with Behind the Money. I'm talking to Daniel Klaus, who's the CEO of Music Nation, and we're talking about how the internet is changing the music industry and the economics of music. Daniel, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Let's just start with talking about Music Nation. It's a very interesting website. Just give us a sense of what Music Nation is all about.
Absolutely. You know, we started Music Nation about a year ago, last April, really to be a community for independent artists. You know, we started it as a place the music business is evolving and changing so quickly, but we felt like the independent artist community really needed a place to be heard and a place to get their music out into the world. And so we started by launching this talent competition in January of this year that really is like American Idol meets YouTube meets CBGBs.
You've already had one of these contests. Who won?
The first contest was amazing. I mean, we launched on January 29th of this year, as I mentioned. We had thousands of bands enter, something like 4,000 bands entered.
Well, let's talk about how the internet and Music Nation is changing how you can do artist development.
You know, the internet has provided a whole new, slew of opportunities to independent artists. You know, before it was really a matter of, you know, finding a really cool A&R guy that was maybe down at CBGB's or down wherever that would see you play and think, that's really cool, we're gonna sign that. But now it's like, you know, anybody can build a MySpace page, they can build a Music Nation page, they can get the word out about their band, they can really connect to fans and build a community around their music. I mean, you know, a kid from Columbus, Ohio can make an unbelievable song, put it up on MySpace or put it up on Music Nation, get millions of plays and, you know, have a song up on iTunes and be selling downloads.
Okay, but are they making any money? I mean, if nobody's buying music, where is the opportunity for business?
You know, where we see an opportunity for business for our business is we're not a record company, we're an artist branding company. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when we use our community, our online community, to help us discover these artists. And then once we discover them, ultimately, you know, we're involved in all the businesses around those artists. So, you know, we want to help artists get on great concert tours. We want to help artists sell merchandise. We want to help them, you know, create great fan clubs that people will pay entry fees for, help them sell ringtones. And, you know, the music is a great commercial for all of that stuff.
You know, one of the things that interests me about Music Nation is one of your partners, who mm-hmm. is Kevin Ryan.
Yes.
And I'm sure, you know, the deal audience will know him because he was the CEO of DoubleClick.
Right.
How did you guys team up and get involved in this?
Kevin and I have known each other for a while. Our third partner is a guy named Peter Reed, who was formerly at VNU. And I've known Peter for many, many years when we both lived in California. And Peter and Kevin went to business school together. And so Peter and Kevin and I had dinner one night, and it did end up with a lot of bottles of red wine philosophizing about the history of the world. And, you know, I really felt like, you know, there was so much change happening in the music business that it was such a great time to be starting a music company right now. And Kevin had an idea of really taking American Idol, YouTube meets American Idol online. So it was just a great fit.
And tell us a little about the financing. You got some venture capital earlier in the year.
Yeah, so we took a little bit of financing from Greylock. We did a Series A with Greylock and with Point Judith Capital.
Who's Point Judith Capital? They have a relationship with a music label.
They're the early stage venture arm of Tudor.
Okay.
Of Tudor, yeah. And so, we're great partners on the finance. They're unbelievably supportive. They've really added a lot of value to our business. So that's been a great relationship for us.
Okay, and last question, let's talk about the future.
Mm-hmm.
5 years from now, 20 years from now, how do you envision consumers consuming music?
I think that it's going to be less about sort of purchasing music as we know it today. It's going to be much more about subscriptions on wireless networks. It's going to be much more about, you know, giving away the music for free, or maybe giving away a few tracks for free and then monetizing all around the equation. But, you know, I'm a big believer in the subscription model. I think that, you know, that cell phone carriers could easily, you know, charge people $5 or $10 a month for unlimited amounts of music. And, you know, if we have 150 million or 200 million cell phone subscribers in the U.S., I don't know what the exact number is, but, you know, the numbers start to add up pretty quickly. So I think that, you know, the music business is going to be very focused on discovering new ways to monetize without actually selling physical product, and then also working with brands.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Daniel Klaus, CEO of Music Nation. And thank you for joining us on Tech Confidential, Behind the Money.